हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम एवरीवन इन साइंस क्लास। दिस इज चंद्रशेखर विश्वकर्मा फ्रॉम जागरण पब्लिक स्कूल वाराणसी, गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द चैप्टर एटम्स एंड मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ क्लास 9th। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मास, लॉ ऑफ डेफिनेट प्रोपोर्शंस, डाल्टन्स एटॉमिक थ्योरी। Law of conservation of mass. In the 18th century, scientists noticed that if they carried out a chemical reaction in a closed container, then there was no change of mass. This preservation of mass in a chemical reaction led to the formation of law of conservation of mass. Law of conservation of mass was given by Antoine Lavoisier in 1774. It states as mass can neither be created nor destroyed in a chemical reaction. In other words, in any chemical reaction, the total mass of reactants is equal to total mass of the products. Now, verification of law of conservation of mass. This law was verified by Landolt. The law can be verified with the help of Landolt experiment. Landolt took the solution of sodium chloride and silver nitrate separately in two limbs of an H-shaped tube. The tube was sealed and weighed. After weighing, the two solutions were mixed thoroughly by shaking the tube. As a result, the reaction occurred between silver nitrate and silver chloride, and white precipitate of silver chloride was formed. After the reaction, the tube was again weighed. It was observed that the weight remained unchanged. This verified the law of conservation of mass. Now, numerical problem based on law of conservation of mass. When 10 gram of calcium carbonate is decomposed completely, 5.6 gram of calcium oxide is formed. Calculate the mass of carbon dioxide formed. For the solution of this question, what is chemical reaction? The chemical reaction is, on heating calcium carbonate, calcium oxide and carbon dioxide form. Here reactant is calcium carbonate and the product is calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. Now mass of reactant is equal to mass of calcium carbonate is equal to 10 gram and mass of product is equal to mass of calcium oxide plus mass of carbon dioxide. From the law of conservation of mass, we have mass of reactant is equal to mass of product. After solving, we will obtain the mass of carbon dioxide, 4.4 gram. Now, law of definite proportions. A chemical compound is always made up of same elements combined together in a fixed proportion by mass. This law was given by Joseph Louis Proust in 1779. Verification of law of definite proportion. To verify this law, consider the formation of copper oxide. Copper oxide can be prepared by heating copper carbonate or by heating copper nitrate or by heating copper in the presence of oxygen. Now we shall take three different sample A, B and C of copper oxide prepared from different sources. These weigh amount of copper oxide is separately heated in a current of hydrogen till copper oxide changes to copper and water. In each sample, the weigh of copper and water are measured. It was found that in all three samples of copper oxide, the percentage of copper and oxygen is the same. In other words, the ratio of weights of copper and oxygen in the three samples of copper oxide is the same. Now, numerical problem based on law of definite proportions. Hydrogen and oxygen combine in the ratio of 1:8 by mass to form water. What mass of oxygen gas would be required to react completely with 3 gram of oxygen gas? Now, solution of this question. Since hydrogen and oxygen combine in the ratio of 1:8 by mass, it means that for x gram of hydrogen, 8x gram of oxygen will be required to form water. Therefore, oxygen required to react with 3 gram hydrogen to form water is equal to 3 multiplied by 8 is equal to 24 gram. Now, Dalton's atomic theory. According to Dalton's atomic theory, all matter, whether an element, compound or mixture, is composed of small particles called atoms. The postulates of this theory is, all matter is made up of very tiny particles called atoms. Atoms are indivisible particles which cannot be created or destroyed in a chemical reaction. Atoms of given element are identical in mass and chemical properties. Next, postulates. Atoms of different elements have different masses and chemical properties. Atoms can combine in ratio of a small whole number to form compounds. The relative numbers and kinds of atoms are constant in a given compound. Now, practice question for you. How much oxygen will add with 36 gram carbon to give 132 gram of carbon dioxide, assuming complete combustion of carbon? This question can be solved by application of law of conservation of mass. Now, next question. Calculate the mass of carbon present in 2 gram of carbon dioxide. This question can be solved by application of law of definite proportions. Which postulates of Dalton atomic theory is the result of the law of conservation of mass? Next question, very important question. Which postulates of Dalton atomic theory can explain the law of definite proportions? Thank you so much for watching video.